very painstaking job and requires considerable skill to keep the weave uniform. Thus, the kasti is a flattened tube of white wool about 1/4 inch in width. It is composed of 72 very fine white and woolen interwoven threads. Weaving is completed on reaching the required length. The woven kasti, which is circular, having no end, is then taken off the juntar and sent to a Zoroastrian priest for consecration.
Snotra remes dao ashem vohu estem asti ustas te ustam mayat saive stayasem paname yasdan uramas da kodayava zuningu ze koreva ziad sarosh asho tagitan farma.
A Zoroastrian priest cuts the kasti while reciting the kasti kapvani nirang.
Aunem vairim tanum paite, aunem vairim tanum paite.
A sacred prayer to cut the kasti.
Kem namas dama vaite paim dadasta vaite sasahe. Womananga timna sacha yavista satracha yavinya frasto timvacho yasnim azareyam racha. Ashem. Vohu vaistem asti ustasti ustammai yatashai vaistai ashem. Yatha ohu vairiyo atharato zasachi dacha vangeus dasdamaningo shyota nanam. Ashem vohu vaistem asti ustasti.
And returns it back to the weaver.
Yat asai vahistai asem.
Next process is supposed to be the most difficult part of the entire making of kasti.
The woven kasti is turned inside out with the help of the suyo.
The two ends of the strong thread are tied in a special way and the knots are again stitched so that the thread doesn't slip. Separate the ends of the kasti in two equal parts. Take 8 threads from each half. And tie the balance into the loop of the strong thread on the needle. Insert the blunt needle into the hollow of the kasti. Thus, the process of turning the kasti inside out begins.
During the weaving process, it may have been necessary to add yarn with a small knot. There may also be other minor blemishes on the outside of the tube. Since the tube is quite long and very narrow, this has to be done with great care. A kasti, made of very fine yarn, has a very narrow and more delicate tube and could break during this process, rendering several days of work useless. The maker then knots the last unwoven portion of wrap grouped in 9 divisions of 8 threads each. Unwoven threads at both ends are braided to form 4-faced lurs or plaits, one at each end. And then interlaced in 3 lurries, plaits, to form tassels, each of 24 threads, representing 3 principles of Zoroastrianism, which are good thoughts, good words, and good deeds. So, at both the ends, there are in all 1 lur and 3 lurries. By now, the kasti is ready in raw form. Now, the customization process begins. First, kasti is cleaned with soap and water. Then, the kasti is given a facelift by a process called dhoop gandhak apvi, that is sulphur bleaching. In a small fulu, that is vessel, gandhak, that is sulphur, is placed over rak, that is ashes and burning coal. Woven kasti is then circled around the vessel on an old sadra. All the above is then covered with a matinu boyu or agwad, that is an earthen bowl. This process lasts for around half an hour. Then the kasti is again washed with plain water and tightly mounted and rolled over a thick, broad wooden saraiyu, that is a cylindrical rod, usually covered with a sadra for drying, stretching and strengthening so as to mold it in a flat strip. Then the properly flattened kasti is delicately rolled and wound around itself into a circular shape, tied up and pressed between 2 wooden boards to give it the proper final shape. Finally, kasti is ready for sale or is gifted to family and friends. Fascinating, isn't it? Alas, with kasti weaving paying very poorly for the time and skill it requires, we are now facing a shortage of kasti weavers. Can this noble art be revived? Are we willing to pay the price to revive it? We leave you with that thought.
Yazdan Panabad. May God be with all of us.